You know, we just saw Bob and Doug, and I think all of us are going to have memories now for the rest of our lives when they launched. In fact, we'll have memories of the day that they didn't launch, and then 3 days later coming back and doing the whole thing again, not knowing whether or not they were going to go 50-50 on the weather. And then sure enough, the skies opened up and we were able to launch Bob and Doug.
Ignition. Liftoff of the Falcon 9 and Crew Dragon. Go NASA, go SpaceX. Godspeed, Bob and Doug.
I want to say a few words just about what champions they are beyond just being the first crew to fly on Dragon. It goes beyond that. They knew that when they were doing this, it was a test flight. They also knew that they were going to be responsible for, you know, conducting a lot of operations on the International Space Station for a period of months, to include what ended up being 4 spacewalks, spending that extended period of time on the International Space Station, and then flying back, and amazingly coming off the jet just right now after being weightless for the last 63 days, coming off the jet, sitting down, and doing a public event. And I got to tell you, I've never flown into space, but from my, that's not normally done. It's very difficult. But they wanted to take that opportunity to connect with the American people on this momentous occasion. And I can't say how much, you just can't put into words how important this was for our country to have access to space again from our own soil. Congratulations to Bob and Doug and their families. What an amazing day for the United States of America. I would also say that what we just saw is the beginning of what will be a whole lot more activity in the future. Right now, when we talk about commercial crew, we're going to go for the Dragon. We're going to go from development into operations. Of course, we're always going to learn and we're always going to modify, but making that transition from development to operations is going to be a challenge, but the NASA team is up for it. But it goes beyond that because we still have Starliner, and we need to get Starliner flying. And then we've got to get Orion flying, and we've got to get Starship flying. So look, there is a lot to do in front of us, but here's what we know. We know that when members of Congress come together in a bipartisan way and they fund NASA, amazing things can happen. Right now we have before the House and the Senate the biggest budget request in NASA's history in nominal dollars. By the way, right now we have the biggest budget NASA has ever had in nominal dollars. We're heading the right direction. And next year, if we get the budget request that is before us right now, next year, we're going to go up an order of magnitude. And that is necessary because today we're flying into low Earth orbit. And in a few short years, we want to be flying to the moon and not just go once or twice, but we want to go sustainably with a purpose. We're going to the moon sustainably. We're going to learn how to live and work on another world for long periods of time. We're going to use the resources of the moon in order to live and work, and we're going to take all of that knowledge onto Mars. That's what we're able to accomplish because of the bipartisan support we've had in the House and in the Senate for the budget that we have right now. And what I'm asking for our members of Congress to do is look at what we've done with what we have, and if you fund us at our budget request level, we will be on the moon. And we will be successfully on the moon with our commercial partners and with our international partners. So today was an amazing day. It was a historic day. It's been 9 years since America launched and landed from its own soil. And yet here we are. But the next step is we're going on to the moon and then on to Mars. This is about momentum. It starts today and it finishes when we put an American flag on Mars. I've said it before and I'll say it again. NASA seeks to be one customer of many customers in a very robust commercial marketplace in low Earth orbit. And we want to have numerous providers that compete on cost and innovation and safety. And I will tell you, there was a moment we had some significant challenges. We might have had a few disagreements on parachutes. We might have had maybe a disagreement on, maybe we need to change the titanium and because of its reactivity with nitrogen tetroxide. And I sent a tweet, Elon, and I know you remember this. And since we've had a number of dialogues, I sent a tweet and I said that it's time to deliver. And I tweeted it at Elon Musk. And I want to tell you, Elon, you responded absolutely, magnificently, And you have, in fact, delivered. You have delivered beyond anything any of us would have expected. And I will also say that all of the reports I'm getting from all of the teams on commercial crew is that this mission went as good as we could have hoped. And we're so grateful for the team at SpaceX, the great team in NASA's commercial crew program, and all of the operators that helped us to get to this point.